All right. Exchange for Media Group, ladies and gentlemen, was set up in the year I was born, which is the year 2000, with the aim of publishing niche, relevant, and quality publications for the marketing, advertising, and media professionals. Now, today, Exchange for Media is actually a single-stop information platform for the entire industry news, views, analytical information, in-depth analysis of events or trend forecasting. Exchange for Media publications have credible and loyal following. Ladies and gentlemen, there's someone I look up to, take advice from, guidance from, the powerful force. Welcome on stage, Chairman and Editor-in-Chief of BW Business World and Exchange for Media Group, Mr. Annurag Batra. Good morning, Annurag. How are you doing, sir? No, I forgot my socks. Yes, sir. Can I use your socks? What they do in fashion, man? Remove socks, short pants, whatever, man.
You know, I want to tell you a story, Siddharth. Morning, when I grow up, I want to be like you. Right? Me, Nawal, and Amit started this company 18 years back, and we started from my father's house, and we had, you know... And Amit and Nawal and me would meet on Saturday. And they would, one Saturday, they came in Bermudas, half pants. And my dad, normally a reticent person, doesn't crack joke, doesn't talk too much. And he asked us, and he's always particular about being well-dressed and being clean-shaven and so on. And he asked Amit and me and Nawal and say, why are you dressed like this? So they joked with him and said, today is half day, so half Bermudas. Saturday, so my dad said, please don't come tomorrow. Tomorrow is a Sunday. So I hope you stay on your socks itself. You don't go beyond that. Yeah. So it's my honor and privilege to be here. ITMA is in its 8th year. The Tech Munch is in its 2nd year. And we are talking about digital media and digital advertising. Today you have leaders from across the globe who will tell you about digital advertising and digital marketing. I was thinking, what would I say to this group of people who know more than me about brands, digital advertising? And I was coming back from Dubai early this morning, and I was reading newspapers. Newspapers still get published, they get read. Magazines get published, they get read. And by all age groups, the first thing I want to say, that the more digital, I was reading about what other print products are doing. Facebook's launched a magazine. But I wanted to, throughout the day, Mr. Chawla is here, my friend Deepak is here, I see Lloyd, see lots of friends. But two things, I had originally prepared a presentation, and two things got my mind. This was an article I read in the FT, which talked about how the more connected we are, the danger of cyber warfare become a reality, and not, you know, far from today. And so the first thing I wanted to say to all of you is that when we think of digital and we think of connectivity, we're not thinking of the dangers of cyber warfare. Just to quote from the article, by its nature, electronic warfare is cheaper, quicker, and far easier to camouflage than physical kind. Targets can be broadly drawn, nuclear power stations, and you know, really, when I read this article, I got paranoid. So while the Indian digital advertising, marketing, media ecosystem grows, out of the 80,000 crores that get spent in this ecosystem, digital is already at about 16,000 crores, which is 20%, and growing faster than anything. I think as leaders of the community and business people and entrepreneurs, we have to focus, we have to be conscious of the checks and balances that we need to put into place for data, for security. The second is on 11 June, 14 June is Donald Trump's birthday, 12 June was the US-Korea summit, but 11 June was a bad day for the internet. Can you tell me why it was a bad day for the internet? Why was 11 June? It was the end of the dream of net neutrality. And we're not thinking about it. You know, I also tend to think about how much advertising, you know, how much money is coming into this domain. Net neutrality is dead now, at least for now. And that, for consumers, and for entrepreneurs and for smaller players in the digital ecosystem is not a good thing, because more and more power will go towards larger players, and that's not necessarily a good thing either for the ecosystem or the consumers. The third thing, we know that most of the digital advertising in India, out of the 15,000 crores, about 11,000 crores, which is all a little less than $1.8 billion, goes to Facebook and Google. But the quality of content that is being generated is not exactly the kind of content that we would want our readers to read, you know, the citizens to read. So, and I'm not talking of just fake news, I'm just saying the quality of content is not necessarily the kind of content that we would want society to get impacted with, our kids to get impacted. So today, while we celebrate digital advertising, we celebrate the democratization of content, of access, of being able to reach out to whoever we want, whenever we want, in the way we engage, how programmatic is growing. And I don't even want to talk about the negatives of, you know, digital advertising, how much money went waste in advertising because bots were seeing those advertising. You know, we know that P&G cut its budget. But I really wanted you to focus on the three things I mentioned, and last but not the least, we all have become screenagers. We spend a lot of time on our screens. You and me are screenagers, Siddharth. We may not be teenagers anymore. Is the impact on the emotional well-being of young people, of people from all ages? We need to bring, again, we cannot restrict, we cannot impose regulations. That's the nature of the digital world. But we need to create some kind of norms. And I was jokingly saying that the finance minister could have done away with the GST. Instead of doing a GST, the finance minister should have put a selfie tax. And for the girls, when they pout, 1% more, okay? I also have a 14-year daughter. So I genuinely believe that while we must celebrate the growth of digital, the growth of digital advertising, we must keep these four things. One is cyber warfare, the government is thinking, and today there are cyber armies, and India has done okay. We may not talk about it, but how data theft is becoming big, how identity theft is becoming big. Second, we must not get all the power to get into the hands of, as citizens, we must patronize platforms which are beyond this duopoly. Third, the fact that the social fabric and the emotional well-being of young people is getting impacted with what's happening. So I just wanted to kind of flag these issues, because today we celebrate digital advertising. We must do that, but we must keep in mind that we have a lot, this is a new world. There's a lot to be set in order in this new world as we go along. And I'm sure because the leaders in this room, because at the end of the day, the brands give money to these platforms. If the brand owners can exert influence over these media owners, content owners, technology owners, to be able to put some norms, then I think we can engage with the digital ecosystem much better. I look forward to learning a lot about digital. We were the original digital guys. We started Exchange for Media 17 years, but I think we know very little. And like all of you, I look forward to meeting the winners tonight. Tonight is the 8th edition of IDMA. The jury was chaired by Shri Sanjeev Mehta. He's going to speak today. And I can tell you that the jury was very eclectic, and the way Mr. Mehta ran the jury was exemplary. There's a lot of feedback on the quality of entries, quality of work, how they were presented. But you'll see that at Exchange for Media, you know, jury members are here, Lloyd is here. We are only custodians of the process. Tonight's winners and very impressive list of winners have been selected through a jury process, which is absolutely above board and very honest. So I look forward to celebrating the good work that this ecosystem is doing, and look forward to contributing some thoughts and ideas which can make our ecosystem better. Thank you. God bless you.
Thanks so much, Annurag. Thank you so much. Give it up, Annurag. Your father would be a very happy man, Annurag, because you've turned out pretty well. Clean shaven, great clothes. Give it up.